Ever wonder how many subscriptions you're still paying for? Maybe that meditation app from 2021 or that streaming service you only used that one time. They're probably charging you every month. And if you stick around, I'll show you the easiest way to cancel them once and for all. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to manage your Apple subscriptions on your computer and on your phone. Stick around for my Mac Whisperer power tip, where I reveal two tools that will immediately save you money. If you need more help, drop by the description to download your free smart guide, which explains everything we're going to talk about in this video. Let's hop on over to the computer and get started. Apple's done an amazing job of creating a simple system to manage all of your subscriptions. Unlike other websites and applications that just leave you in the dark about when your next charge is going to happen or how to cancel, Apple has brought all that information in and centralized it in an easy location on your computer and your phone. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. We start off on the computer by coming right down to your Settings app. Once you're in the Settings app, click on your name up at the top. This is where all of your Apple information is located, stored, and organized. Right here, you'll notice a section called Media and Purchases. Let's click on it. From this section, you can manage any of the Apple accounts that are tied to your computer. You'll notice up at the top, I've got one account that I use for most of my media, and down below, I've got a second account that is my master account for other services. You can come right to the subscription section underneath the proper Apple ID and click Manage, just like this. You'll notice all of your active and inactive subscriptions. This is your one-stop shop to find out who's charging you, how much they're charging you, and when your next payment is. In the upper right-hand corner, we've got a sort tool that can allow you to sort by the name of the app, the price of the app, or the next payment date. I always like to set it on the next payment date so I know who's charging me next. The subscriptions panel is broken into two different sections. First, up at the top, we've got the active section. These are any subscriptions that are still functional. As you look through the different subscriptions, you may find some that have a red expiring listing underneath them. These are subscriptions that you've canceled, but that you still have some paid time on, so they haven't deactivated yet. As you scroll further down this list, you'll end up in a section called Inactive. These are subscriptions that you've canceled that are completely defunct. You can renew them if you want to, or just leave them canceled. As we look at each separate entry, you'll see who it is that's charging you, whether it's Paramount or Disney or vidIQ. Underneath that, you'll see what the actual subscription is for: Paramount Plus Premium, Disney Plus Premium, current episodes streaming now. Below that, you'll see when the next charge is going to happen or when your subscription is going to expire. Here we see my Paramount renews on August 6th, but my mini photo booth expires on September 3rd. And to the right of any of your active current subscriptions, you'll see the price that you'll get charged at your next renewal date. At any time, you can renew a canceled subscription by clicking on it and clicking the Renew button up here, or cancel an existing subscription, which will expire at its next renewal date. So it's easy to come through this section and see exactly who's charging you, when, and how much. In addition to checking the ongoing subscriptions for your account, you may need to see a bird's eye view of all of the charges coming into your Apple account. If you have a family plan and you're the organizer of your family plan, you may need to see purchases made by all of the family members, including any subscriptions. It's easy to do that by clicking back on your name and coming back to the Media and Purchases section. This time, instead of just clicking on subscriptions, I'm going to click on Manage, but we're going to do it on my other Apple ID here. Let's click on the Manage button, which will require you to sign into your Apple ID. Once you get signed in, you're going to land on this page. As you scroll down, you can see your purchase history. Clicking See All on the purchase history can show you all sorts of information, not just your subscriptions, but all of your purchases. If you're the organizer of your family account, up here there's a filter that says Last 90 Days Paid. And by clicking on it, you can choose More Than the Last 90 Days, looking at everything from this year. You can look for both paid and free downloads. And by clicking in the type section, you can choose specific purchases you're looking for. If you don't choose anything, it will show all purchases, whether they're apps or subscription, music, videos, or books. Down below that, you can choose which family members you want to see purchases for. And if you're the organizer, you can see purchases from everybody just by selecting them right here. Once you've made the proper selections, click Apply and it'll take you to this page, which shows you every single purchase made by every member in your family. You can see any subscriptions that they've purchased, and you can also see all of the purchases that were bundled together into one payment. Sometimes on our credit card statements, it might just say Apple, and the Apple amount might be a weird amount, like $49.98. And you're thinking to yourself, what subscription do I have that's almost $50 a month? What you may not realize is that Apple bundles recent purchases together, charging once or twice a week rather than every single day. And these separate purchases get bundled together on this page so that you can see that this was the day that The Lost Boys was rented and Hulu renewed, accounting for the $22.98. This is one of the best ways to understand the mystery of what that Apple charge is actually for on your credit card. And as you scroll through here, you'll find a ton of information about what you're paying for, how much it costs, and when it renews. You'll even see things like Apple Care payments, as well as all of the other subscriptions. If you click on any of the totals, it will take you to a separate page where you can report a problem if you have an issue. This is helpful if somebody charged something that you didn't approve, or if something renewed without you realizing it. If you report a problem, Apple will generally refund your price within a couple of days. To do that, find the specific charge that you have an issue with and click on the Report a Problem button here. This will take you to Apple's Report a Problem page, where you can come in and request a refund, report a quality issue, report a scam, or offensive, illegal, or abusive content. I'm going to request a refund. It may ask for additional information, asking you whether it was an accidental purchase or somebody purchased it without permission, or you didn't intend to renew a subscription, or that the purchase doesn't work properly. Once you've done that, click the Next button here. It'll open up this page, which will show you all of your available purchases that you can ask for a refund on. Clicking on any one of them will allow you to request a refund for that purchase or those purchases. Be aware that if you abuse this system and request refunds on everything, Apple can refuse you the refunds and can even cancel and remove your Apple account. So it's really not worth it to request refunds for every little problem. Pick and choose the specific problems, issues like an app that doesn't download properly or a purchase that you did not approve of. So those are some of the best ways that you can manage your Apple subscriptions directly from your Mac. But now, let's step over to the iPhone and let's look at some of the options there. From your iPhone or iPad, you'll start in the same place, opening up your Settings app and coming to your name up at the top. But here is where things may look a little bit different. Up at the top, you may see something that says Subscriptions. If you do, clicking on that will bring you right to the Subscriptions page, allowing you to make any changes that you want to make. We've still got our sort button that can change things into different orders like next payment date, and we still got the active and inactive sections. Clicking on any subscription will take you to a detail page where you can easily cancel it. So that's the same, but the part that's a little bit different is if you want to see your purchase history from your phone. To do that, come down to Media and Purchases. Clicking on that will ask you whether you want to sign out of your current account or view the account you're signed into. I have multiple Apple IDs, and this account is not the one that manages the entire family. So I can come in here and I can view the account, but it's only going to show me this account. I can come into purchase history, but it's not going to allow me to see the accounts from the other members of my family. To do that, we have to sign in to the organizer's account. So the first thing I'm going to do is click here and click sign out. It's going to warn me that signing out is going to remove my Apple ID from many of my Apple services. But it's okay because I'm going to sign right back in. Let's click sign out here, and then we'll click back on Media and Purchases. Now it's going to prompt me to sign in with my master Apple account, which is the correct one in my case. If you have a different Apple ID that you'd like to check purchases on that's not your master account, click where it says not your name and sign in using your email and password for that Apple ID. You can do that for any Apple ID that you need to check purchases on, even if it's an old iTunes account from forever ago. I'm going to click continue. From here, we've got the option to see our subscriptions for this Apple ID. In this case, most of my subscriptions are on the other account. This is just the subscription for my Apple One service. But I can also click here where it says purchase history. And that's going to open to the page we saw on my computer, where I can click up at the top where it says show last 90 days paid. And I can choose a different date range, like this year or custom date range. I can choose paid or free purchases. I can choose any type of purchase, and I can choose any family member or multiple family members. And then I see all the purchases, whether they were in-app purchases, AppleCare purchases, website purchases, or subscriptions. It's an easy and simple way for you to manage your purchases and your subscriptions right from your phone or iPad. Once you're done checking your subscriptions, don't forget to change back to your other Apple ID if you have multiple Apple IDs. For me, I'm going to sign out of the master account and sign back into my media and purchases account by clicking here and clicking where it says not Dylan Stewart. Now all I have to do is sign myself back in. Now I'm all set and ready to go. So we've learned some really powerful tools about how to manage your subscriptions, but there's just one more thing I want to talk about. Before I drop my MacWhisperer power tip, if you've already gotten great value out of this video and you can see how much money you're going to be able to save by managing your subscriptions from your devices, then give this video a thumbs up. That makes it so much easier for other people to find this video. And if you've got a question, a comment, something you didn't understand, drop it down below in the comments section. I love my YouTube community and I love to hear from you guys. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, we're talking about managing subscriptions. Let's manage this subscription. Hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so you're always alerted whenever I drop new content. And with that being said, let's get into the power tip. I've been managing my Apple subscriptions for my entire family on multiple devices for decades now. And in that time, I've learned some really powerful tools that I want to share with you. To use these tools, you can be on your phone, iPad, or computer. But since we're already on the phone, let's stay on the phone. We go back to the Settings app here, back to our name, and back to Subscriptions. From this section, we're going to talk about two very helpful tools. I'm going to make this easier by sorting by next payment date. The first tool is the ability to find sale offers for existing subscriptions. Let me show you what I mean. Let's come into my Paramount Plus account. This is going to charge me $12.99 per month. It's not a ton of money, but if there's a deal, I want it. You see this button in the upper right-hand corner that says See All Plans? Apple makes sure that anytime someone advertises a lower price on any of their subscriptions, they have to show it here. So when you click See All Plans, you're going to get all sorts of options. Maybe I'd like to downgrade my Paramount Plus to just an Essential plan. Or if I look right here, I'm paying $12.99 a month for Paramount Plus Premium, and there's a sale for $11.99 a month. I'm not one to turn down a sale, so let's click that button and let's change my account over to the $11.99 per month account and save me a couple of bucks. And this tip works all over the place and can save you a ton of money. As I come into my Disney Plus subscription, I want you to notice that I also have Hulu Plus. Disney Plus is $15.99 a month and Hulu Plus is $18.99. Between the two of them, that's like 34 bucks a month. Let's come into my Disney Plus subscription and let's check what other plans are available. As I click See All Plans, I can see my Disney Plus Premium at $15.99 a month, but just a little further down, look at that. There's a Disney Plus Hulu bundle for $19.99 a month. That's like $15 less than what I'm currently paying for those two apps. To me, that's an absolute no-brainer. And I'm going to hit that button, change that subscription, cancel my Hulu account, and save myself some moolah. And now for our second tip. which is every bit as valuable as the first one. This tip is most applicable when you purchase an annual subscription rather than a monthly subscription. It's still valuable for the monthly subscription, but not as much. For this example, we're going to come down to the bottom where I purchased this app, WidgetSmith, for a full year. Now, here's the problem with annual subscriptions. Will I still want to use this app a year from now? Will I even remember it? How am I going to feel about getting charged $20 for something I'm not currently using? It's hard to know what we're going to be using or wanting to pay for a year from now, but all of these companies offer a big incentive to pay annually instead of monthly, and it's usually a cheaper price. They know something that we don't know, which is we're going to forget to cancel it before the renewal date. And that's where this tip comes into play, because you don't have to wait to cancel that subscription. I purchased this WidgetSmith subscription today. It's going to renew next August. But maybe I'm not going to want to use it next August. All I have to do is click the cancel subscription button here and confirm this cancellation. It will still be active until the renewal date. And what's nice about doing this is that the company will remind you before it renews because they want you to renew, instead of not reminding you before it charges you because they don't want you to cancel it. This is the best of both worlds, because if you decide you don't need this app a year from now, no problem, it's going to cancel on its own. But if you decide that you still want this app next year, they're going to remind you that it's expiring and you can just renew it. It makes it so easy for you to not hold on to subscriptions and forget about them. Even though it's most valuable for annual subscriptions, there's still value in using this tip for monthly subscriptions. For example, I really like to use this photo booth app to set up my iPad as a photo booth for parties. Here you'll see some of the pictures from my recent party this last weekend. It's super fun and it's super easy, but it's a $40 a month subscription. And I only really need it for the day of the party. So as soon as the party's over, I cancel the subscription and I let it expire. And the next time I want to take amazing pictures, I just renew it and then cancel it immediately after the party. It's a great way to handle your monthly and annual subscriptions so you don't forget about them and accidentally continue paying for them for years and years to come. So that's what we've got for today's video, all about how to properly and easily manage your Apple subscriptions from your computer, iPhone, or iPad. Don't forget to stop by the description to download your free smart guide. This is a simple PDF that will explain everything we talked about in this video and make it easy for you to follow along. I hope you learned a ton today, but as usual, there's always more to learn. Check out this video over here for even more amazing tips and tricks on how to use your Apple devices properly. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and I'll see you in the comments.